Well, your grandmother.
Let me get off. That was quite good.
It's our second day in Copenhagen, in the happiest country in the world, and today we're going to figure out if it's because of the food, because that's what makes me the happiest.
We had just scooted all the way across town, and I think my face might be partially frozen.
We are about to meet with a local foodie, and we're starting the day off right with some coffee.
It smells so good.
So we wanted to make sure that we checked out all the right places and ate all the right foods while we were here in Denmark. So we're meeting with Cindy, who owns a food tour company here in the city, and she's gonna give us all the spots that we have to check out today. I've never seen someone that takes their latte art so seriously. We were just filming the cup of coffee and the lady came up and she was like, oh my goodness, I did not know that you were gonna photograph the coffee. I was in a rush, please let me make you another one. So we'll show you round two, like the beautiful coffee that she's taking the time to make.
Are you ready to see the perfect cappuccino? Coffee culture in Denmark is huge, which was great for me, so I ordered a cappuccino, but our new friend Cindy said that there are some pretty fun, innovative pastries here as well.
Thank you. Wow. Okay, so we just learned about this restaurant called Noma. It's been ranked one of the best restaurants in the entire world, and apparently it's what put Copenhagen on the food scene map. And this little breakfast spot that we're at is an offshoot of Noma. So they have some pretty unique pastries, obviously some beautiful coffees, and I'm about to try this pastry that has a mushroom and beef glaze, but it's supposed to still be like a sweet pastry.
Ooh, that crunch. Mm.
I feel like my palate is not quite sophisticated enough for this kind of food, yet honestly, it tastes like a delicious, buttery croissant with like a sweet glaze on top. Had you not told me that it was mushroom and beef, I would have had no clue. It's like a fine wine. You have to refine your palate to these unique pastries to be able to appreciate them.
Do you like these?
I love them. Favorite sauce.
Nice and caffeinated, ready to eat.
Hey. We just spent the last hour learning so much about the food scene here in Copenhagen, but most importantly, we have this list, the official list of the places that we must eat and the foods that we must try.
This is one of the most excited I've ever been to do a DIY food tour.
We normally go into these things pretty clueless with things that we've read on the internet, but the professional opinion should be very helpful. So we've made our way over to Freetown. It's a place that we didn't expect to find ourselves back at so soon. We actually were here yesterday. It's a super unique area of Copenhagen. It's pretty much a commune that was founded by hippies and now is pretty much completely self-governed.
They're just like me. I'm always about 15 minutes late. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Oh, the hummus looks so good. So the reason we're here is because the first vegetarian restaurant in all of Copenhagen is here in Freetown. And it's very unique, just like the rest of the city. It is run by locals and all of the money goes back into the community. They have all fresh vegetarian meals, different every single day. First, we ordered the soup of the day. It's chickpea with ginger. It has these huge chunks of squash and zucchini topped with some fresh dill. A giant piece of bread that she cut straight from the loaf. Then we got a salad plate. We have hummus, some kind of potato, cauliflower, onion salad, and a rice noodle salad. I think it might be Asian. It all looks incredible. I'm very happy about this because it's cold today. It seems like a perfect way to warm up. Oh, that is so good. It is bursting with flavor. So there's like the burn of the ginger, but it's also like buttery smooth. It's like if you mixed a hearty potato soup, like the thickness and the savoriness of a potato soup with a hint of ginger. It is seriously the best combination. I've never had anything like it. Now let's salads. So the guy who recommended this soup was actually rolling a you-know-what at the table behind us. That's why we had to change positions. But now he left. Now for the salads. I'm just going to eat a bite of this hummus with a fork because I think it's going to be that good. Mm. Okay, so this is legit. I can taste like everything that's in here. Mushed up chickpeas. Some kind of nut is smushed in here. Maybe like walnut with sesame seeds on top. Hint of salt. Some kind of like pepper oil. Like, you know, the olive oil that has like peppers infused inside. That's incredible. Nice and cold. The balance to the hot soup. Now for the potato salad. It's so savory. I felt like we were coming here more for just the novelty of it being the first vegetarian restaurant, like eating in such a unique place. I did not expect the food to be this good. And good for you.
Since this place is run by volunteers, you're expected to help out.
I cannot get over it.
The lady who was serving us the food, like as she was putting the food on the plate, she was like, don't make a commercial about this place. So so don't go here. They don't
Leave
want more people.
Leave them alone.
So we just come to this super cool bakery that was obviously built in an old warehouse, but they've painted everything white and all the employees are wearing white and it just has like this super clean modern vibe. But we come here in search of a specific pastry. It's called a Wienerbrot and it translates to pastry of Vienna. But in the US, it's what we think of as a Danish. But Danishes don't exist in Denmark. Instead, they call it a pastry from somewhere else. A pastry from Vienna. Cindy, the girl that we had coffee with this morning, told us that when she went to the US, she got a Danish just to see what it was. And she was like, yeah, we definitely don't have these in Denmark. I just think it's so funny that nobody wants to claim the Danish. The Americans say that it's from Denmark, and the Danish say that it's from Vienna. We'll trace it back to its roots one day. So that's what we came here to get. Unfortunately, they're already sold out because it's 2 p.m., so I ended up with this sugary cracker thing. Oh, with like some spicy cardamom.
So in addition to not eating Danishes, they also never ever put cheese on their not Danish Danishes. She said if they put anything on their thing that we call a Danish, it would be custard or jam. But if you'd asked me before we came here what the Danish people eat, I would have said a cheese Danish. Not at all.
I like it in here.
So we've just come right around the corner to a brewery. It's another converted warehouse and it's really cool. We came here because Cindy suggested it. And honestly, we just needed somewhere to sit down and sit on our phones for a minute because we didn't know whenever we post a new video, I take the first hour and I sit down and I just respond to all of the comments. So if you're watching this video in the first hour, leave me a comment. We try to post every other day. It doesn't always happen. But when we do, it's at 7 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Leave me a comment. Likes?
Gotta burn calories so we can eat more.
We've taken so long to get from place to place. We're doing a food tour and I'm hungry.
We came back to the center of town to a restaurant called Selma. Now it doesn't have a Michelin star, but it's been mentioned in the Michelin guide, which is a really big deal. We're very excited to be here. And we're here for two things. The first one is another smorgasbord. We tried this yesterday, but when we told our friend that we had already had it, she said, no, it is 1,000 times better at Selma. So of course we had to come try another one. But this time we got it with herring. It's raw fish. It's very traditional. We had it one other time in Holland and it wasn't bad. I think this one is going to be much better. It is marinated in black currant vinegar and it has these beautiful flower petals of black currant powder on top. It's almost too pretty to eat. Of course we're gonna eat it. But we've been told that you can't have herring without this, the local homemade aquavit. It is a very strong liquor. The waiter here told us that you take one bite of herring, one sip of this. This was $10. We're just gonna sip it slowly and make it last as long as possible. You think I use a fork or do you think I just eat it with my hands?
I think we're at a restaurant that almost has a Michelin star and you should use a fork.
Yes.
We use the street food tours.
Let's dig into this onion. Okay, here we go. The closest I've ever been to eating at a Michelin star restaurant. Okay, wow. I just had a little moment there. That was such a good bite. I like never wanted it to end. When I first put it in my mouth, it was like all the crumbly seediness of the rye bread is the first thing I noticed. And that started breaking down. And then I really tasted the blackcurrant herring. Like it's kind of sweet. And then this really just does make everything go down. Like it's like all gone. I don't really taste fish or onion anymore, which are two very strong flavors. Definitely one of the more expensive stops we've made on a food tour, but it is worth it. This is fun.
We're about to hop back on the bikes to drive to a new neighborhood to try a unique twist on a Danish specialty.
Five. They closed 2 hours ago. I'm very sad. Okay, round two. Let's try this again. Everybody knows that we love trying the local favorites, and the Danish people love their hot dogs. They love everything pork, but they really love hot dogs. The problem is, I have not eaten a hot dog in 3 years. About 3 years ago, I had a hot dog at the zoo, gave me food poisoning, and it was really scarring, and I haven't had one since. But that changes today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Perfect.
My first hot dog in 3 years, but it's not what you think. This is a vegan hot dog. Apparently, the Danish cuisine has changed a lot in the last few years. They're really going towards sustainability, freshness, seasonal, organic. So this isn't like a normal Danish meal, but it is becoming more popular. It's also very unique because you can choose your own dog and your own toppings. So we got a chili-infused dog with banh mi toppings because...
Mm. Oh, it's a huge bite.
I love it. The meat is very tender and soft. I don't know what it is. I'm calling it meat, but it's making a huge mess. So many things going on. There's even some corn in here. I've never had a hot dog with this many toppings. I think there might be some beets in there.
It's very hard to eat. I'm gonna say it's good, but it's not a hot dog.
So I went back in and asked, and apparently the hot dog is made 50% out of just vegetables. Then there's quinoa, chickpeas, some spices, and some kind of protein that she didn't know the English word for. Very healthy.
That's a big benefit. Like, I feel really gross after I eat a hot dog. Like, before I eat it, it sounds like a really good idea, and then you eat the hot dog, and you're like, But this, like, you can feel good about yourself after you eat it, so I kind of understand it. And it's better for the environment. Okay. All right, I'm coming around to the vegan hot dog as I'm sitting here. So the good news about the hot dog place being closed last night is that we were gonna have to resume this video today anyway because we were actually waiting for the street food area to open up. Today is opening day of the season and we've been given several foods to try here. I can't talk, my mouth is so cold from the bike ride, it's like, it's not even working.
That's it.
Thank you so much. All right, we're sitting in the sunshine, trying to warm up a little bit, and we are about to compare the vegan hot dog that we just ate with the traditional Danish hot dog. This is an organic all pork hot dog on a brioche roll with relish and then pickled purple onions. And I don't know if this is traditional or not, but I added some ketchup and mustard because that's the American thing to do. That is a quality hot dog. Completely different than the hot dogs that we're used to eating in the US where they're like kind of like weird and pink inside and you can't really tell like what meat you might be eating. This looks almost like all white meat in the middle and it has like a really nice hearty substance to it. Kara, I'm very sad that you can't experience this.
I honestly do feel like I'm missing out a little
you
bit.
You are missing out. Do it. Do it.
I can't
you
do
can
it.
Do it.
I'm not ready. Perfect. Thank you. This feels so good on my hands. It's so warm. this is the next local dish that we're trying. It's called, oh man, good. I tried to repeat the guy saying it. I'm having a really hard time with the Danish language. But it translates to porridge. And basically what they've tried to do is redefine the porridge. Something that is sophisticated and has nice flavors. And it's not just plain breakfast porridge. I went with this nice, cozy, warm apple cinnamon peanut butter flavor. It just seemed like the coziest one in this cold weather. And I'm so excited. Oh my gosh, it's not peanut butter, it's caramel. Oh, it's warming me right up. They have definitely redefined oatmeal for me. Good job, Grid.
I think we may have to get two of those. That's one of the most jealous I've ever been.
Oh yeah, I'm going for a second one.
For sure.
You have two more.
The best burger in Copenhagen.
Is it warm?
Yes.
I'm colder right now than I was sleeping in the ice cabin. I'm just gonna say that. I'm twice as cold as I was sleeping in the ice cabin. I'm just not dressed properly. We didn't know.
Oh.
All right, here we go. Last food of the video. This is not at all Danish, we don't think. But the interesting thing is we sent out an email asking like what we should do and the foods that we should try while we were here. And we got as many recommendations for this hamburger from Gasoline Grill as we did for like all of the local food.
It's a cheeseburger.
So I felt like we couldn't leave without trying it.
What's funny to me is I went up there to order and there was one option, cheeseburger. There's no like different kinds or toppings.
Wow.
The world famous, actually.
Oh, wait, we're losing.
You're
paper.
Losing your, all right, the Copenhagen famous. Gasoline burger.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Why do you always have the napkins?
Because the wind is blowing.
You
nailed the
napkin.
Okay, the sauce is amazing.
It's a delicious burger.
It tastes like yum-yum sauce, like out of hibachi, the white sauce. The toasted bun is a great touch.
The bun is beautiful.
It's 100% all natural, ground beef, grounded daily.
It's warm, the cheddar is very sharp.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very nice piece of cheddar cheese on there.
Amazing.
Perfect amount of pickles and onions. I'm just being annoying now. It is really good though.
All right, that is gonna do it for our Copenhagen food tour. This was, without a doubt, the most expensive DIY food tour that we've ever done. I haven't calculated up the total yet, but I'm sure it's gonna be a lot. It's gonna be painful
maybe,
to look at.
Maybe we shouldn't calculate the total.
The crazy thing is we stuck to like street food and mid-range food places, and you could get so much more expensive. Like one of the nicest restaurants in the entire world is located here. So there's like this entire fancy food scene that we didn't even get into. But with all that said, it's been a fantastic couple of days eating our way through Copenhagen. And I think if you spread it out through a week trip, it really wouldn't be that bad.
All right, you can go get some dessert. Yeah. Leave us a comment.
That was a really bad wink. I didn't realize really I can't too. Wink my right eye.
Really?
It's so much easier for me to wink my left. So don't go here.
What happened to the second napkins you got?
I put them in my pocket.
You sabotaged me on the camera.
What a napkin. Wow.
I heard it good.